sisters, we came out here to edify y'all and bring y'all back to who you're supposed to be according to the script. Give me 1 Timothy 4:1. Because sister says something about faith. Let me show you what's happening in the earth right now. Our people have an inclination of what faith is, but have really no idea. I'm going to show you what's happening. 1 Timothy 4:1.
1 Timothy 4:1. Now the Spirit speaketh expressly.
The Spirit is talking about this Bible. Read.
That in the latter times.
So in the last days, in the latter times, when we in the end times, which is now, read.
Some shall depart from the faith.
A lot of our brothers and sisters have departed from the faith, have departed from the ways that was given only to the so-called Black, Native American, and so-called Hispanics that you see on this sign. We've fallen away from the things that we were given to govern this planet. We were the rulers in this earth. Read.
Giving heed to seducing spirits.
So we giving heed to seducing spirits. What's that? Christianity, so-called Islam, the woman is God, all these different things. We giving heed to these seducing spirits that are not of what the Bible told us, how the Lord told us to govern this earth. Seducing spirits, read.
And doctrines of devils.
Doctrines of who?
Doctrines of devils.
Anything outside of the scriptures that teach that you, my brother, are the head, is a doctrine of a devil. You understand that? This is one of them cities where brothers love to get behind the sisters. This is the queen city, as a matter of fact. Brothers get behind sisters and push the sisters to get on welfare, get on Section 8. And then when they get their income tax check, she give you the check, then you take it to the corner to flip it. What is that?
Doctrines of devils.
That's a doctrine of a devil, to put the woman out there in front. Give me Jeremiah, keep reading that.
Was that it?
Yes, sir.
Give me Jeremiah 31:22. Because our sister, it's a role for our sisters. I seen you move when I said that, sis, but I'm going to tell you what the Bible say. We ain't out here to cause no confusion. We here to wake our people up.
That's
and bring
right.
The truth, the real edification.
You know.
The way that the Most High structured this thing, give me that in Corinthians 11 first. The way the Most High instructed us to do this is all the way out of order. This is a prime example. This is how the structure is supposed to be for the so-called Black man's household. Read.
1 Corinthians 11:3. But I will have you know that the head of every man is Christ.
So the head of all of us, brothers, is Christ. Read.
And the head of the woman is the man.
Man, you supposed to be in the head of your woman. Not meaning ruling over her and treating her like a damn dog, but mistreating her, sleeping around on her, having multiple women, multiple jump-offs. You supposed to be the head of your household. If you live in that house, she ain't supposed to be getting food stamps and Section 8 welfare. You supposed to be going to work to provide for that woman and them children.
Right.
Read.
And the head of Christ is God.
So the structure right there just said, God is the head, and then it's Christ, and then it's men, and then it's our women.
I don't know.
The problem is, our men that got so comfortable with the Willie Lynch syndrome that we done let the woman get on out there and let her stay out there.
Bring it out.
And now she running things. Because the issue is our women is the ones that's out in the front taking all the blows to the chin. That's not their rightful place. Here's the problem with that. Read. Because a man, it take a man to raise a son, right? It take a woman to teach a daughter how to be a woman. Ain't no man gonna be able to sit there and really emotionally identify with a little girl. That's a woman's job. Ain't no woman gonna really be able to sit there and identify with a future king and teach him how to be a man in this earth. Here's the problem with that. Read.
Isaiah 3:12. As for my people, children are their oppressors.
So who do we see on the corners playing the knockout game? The scripture said children are our oppressors. Here's why.
Read.
And women rule over them.
Who rule over the children?
And women rule over them.
That's the issue, brothers. We just gave you the structure. The Bible said that the man is supposed to be the head of the household. But now you got a lot of single parent households with the women in the place of the man. The woman getting up at 3 and 4 in the morning to hear what that creaking sound was with the Glock. When it's supposed to be a man there, married to that sister, taking care of business. But it said, what? What's the problem?
And women rule over them.
Women are ruling over these children. That's the reason why you see the earth in dismay right now. We got a lot of emotional young men out here with mommy's emotions and handguns. A lot of our brothers ain't accustomed to how a father, a real man that go to work from 9 to 5 or more, and then come home, a lot of our young men have no idea about how that feels. Or to even have a dialogue with a man like that. We can talk too loud to a brother, he'd be ready to pop a cap in us. Because they're not used to the dialogue of a man. Give me Esdras 5:8. Give me 2 Esdras 5:8.
Because here's the problem.
It's an issue. And we got to correct that, my brother. You got a flyer? Contact us. Sister, you got a flyer? Y'all got sons? Y'all got children out here? Reach out to the men of God so we can get our nation back together. Because that's what we out here for. It's time out. Game time is over. They got every single thing pointing at you, so-called black men. All the penitentiaries is filled up with men that look just like you. And they steady building new prisons.
We can get out.
$10,500 a month to house one inmate. Imagine if they gave you $10,500 out here. What could you do with that for your family and for future generations? But it costs $10,500 to feed you some stale bologna and old oranges and orange drink 3 times a day and cookies, what they serve in the Justice Center. $10,500. So I behoove you, brother, stay and listen to this. Read what you got.
2 Esdras 5:8.
Because this is the problem in the earth right now. Read.
There shall be a confusion also in many places.
So in many places, we got mass confusion. Mass confusion amongst the so-called blacks, Native Americans, and Hispanics in the earth. We confuse. Why?
And the fire shall be off sent out again.
So we constantly being put in the fire of disparity, getting put to sleep in the street like we some animals. They got animal shelters for dogs. But our people out here dying on the street, they got laws that protect dogs more than laws that protect you. Read.
And the wild beasts shall change their places.
Read.
And mistress women.
And what?
And mistress women shall bring forth monsters.
These young men out here is monsters, brother. They monsters out here. Why? Because they ain't no daddy. That structure started being tampered with all the way back in the 40s and 50s. When they started giving, and the suffrage movement, when they made the women start feeling like they had to be equal, all that ain't nothing new under the sun. That happened in the very beginning.
Bring it out.
Our sisters got put in that situation because the slave master, like the officer was just bringing out, was uncomfortable with the black man. So he had to make the woman the watchdog so he can get rest. So what they do, tar and feather the black man, chain you to 2 or 3 horses and pull you apart in front of the black woman. Rape you in front of your wife and children, black man. Emasculate you so she wouldn't have her normal dependency on you anymore. Now she looking at you like you just a worthless nigga. Now look at the snowball effect. That's the problem with our people. Read that in Jeremiah.
Jeremiah 31:22. How long wilt thou go about, O backsliding daughter?
Read.
For the Lord hath created a new thing in the earth.
So this is a new thing in the earth, brother. This is a new thing in the earth. You was always rulers. You was always meant to be rulers. Look at this, for instance. Y'all hip to the Black Panther Party, right? How old are y'all brothers, if you don't mind me asking? How old are you, my brother? You 25, and how old are you?
31.
Okay, so look, The Black Panther Party, they age group range from 16 to 40. Look at the age group, I would say even less than that. Because what's the brother that, the movie that just came out about him, the Black Messiah?
Judas.
He was 22 years old when he got put to death. That's the age group. Our young men had that spirit in them to raise up at an early age because it's just in you, it's innate. You can't fight it. You know you greater than what you've been taught that you are out here. Don't you feel that? Can't you feel that in your spirit that they've been, it's something that ain't being told to you. This is what it is.
Bring it out.
That you God's chosen people.
That's right.
And the prophets is out here to tell you today that it's time to repent. Learn who you are. This ain't no white man's book. They told you that because they don't want you to read it. The same goes if you want to hide something from a nigga, put it in a book. The fact is, the greatest men that ever walked the planet look just like you. Just like you, according to this book that's supposed to be the so-called white man's book. This your history book. Give me some color. Let's start with my favorite one, Solomon 1 and 5. Solomon, the son of King David, the richest black king to ever rule in the earth.
Right.
They talk about Albert Einstein was a genius. Now, King Solomon was a genius. Let's see who he looked like. Read.
Song of Solomon, chapter 1 and verse 5. I am black.
He said, what?
I am black.
Now, if a white man wrote this book, wouldn't he have taken that out of there? I would have. If I was an Edomite, I'd have took that out of there. So y'all wouldn't know who you are, but they can't. Read it again.
Song of Solomon, chapter 1 and verse 5. I am black, but comely.
He said, I'm black and handsome. Don't that sound like a brother? Read.
O ye daughters of Jerusalem,
read.
As the tents of Kedar.
Those are black, jet black. Read.
As the curtains of Solomon.
Those are jet black. If you read the history on the way that he wanted the man, his kingdom, the temple built, he gave them specific instruction. Give me these jet black curtains. He said, I'm black like the tents of Kedar, which means black. I'm black like them curtains. He was black. That's right. Read.
Look not upon me because I am black. Because the sun hath looked upon me.
What happened when we stay in the sun too long? We get blacker because the sun love us. What happened to them other nations when they lay in the sun? Them so-called red men. The sun tear them up. The sun is, the earth is for us. That's why. We gonna prove that next. The Jews, the original real Jews, which is who we are, not them so-called Amalekites that's over there in the land, in our homeland, we the real Jews. Read.
Job, chapter 30 and verse 30. My skin is black upon me.
He said what?
My skin is black upon me.
He said my skin is black. Now give me what I wanted in Jeremiah 14, 2. I gave you the wrong script. He said his skin is black, brother. This your book.
Bring it out.
Read.
Jeremiah chapter 14 and verse 2. Judah mourning and the gates thereof languish. They are black.
Judah is what?
They are black.
Now let me ask you a question. According to this sign, who is your father? Look at the names on the right, I believe. Who's your father? What's his nationality according to the sign? What's your nationality according to this? Judah, right? You Judah? Read that again.
They are
read
black.
The top.
Jeremiah chapter 14 and verse 2. Judah mourning.
Judah mourning. We're in a state of mourning. Why? Because we're being treated like worse than humans. Subhuman, subspecies. We're in a state of mourning because we're seeing our people getting shot down in the street. We're seeing our women being abused and abducted at the most alarming rate. 75,000 women gone. All women. No Amber Alert, no nothing. Gone. We're in a state of mourning as a people, bruh. And they not doing nothing to find them. When we try to go online to do our part to get out here and help find our people, they don't even have pictures by the faces. What's that about? It said Judah what?
Judah mourneth. And the gates thereof languish.
Our leaders languish. Why? Because they don't, we really don't have a leader outside of Christ. The Most High Christ and the prophets. But these so-called leaders that they call leaders like Jesse Jackson, Al Sharpton, T.D. Jakes, Creflo Dollar, and them, they languish because they don't have the truth that we given to you. They've been had this same Bible in their churches for decades, and ain't none of this truth ever came out. You just learn more in 5 minutes than you ever learned in Christianity. Read.
They are black.
They are what?
They are black.
Judah, the real Judites are black.
That's right.
Black. Guess who else is from the tribe of Judah?
Bring it out.
King David. Guess who else is from the tribe of Judah?
No.
Jesus Christ.
Yes,
get that. Let's prove it. Because they sold you this image right here and told you that this is what Jesus Christ looked like. That's one of the biggest damn lies that ever been told in this earth.
T-chock.
They told us that this looked like Jesus. Then they tell you, when you tell them the truth, the scriptures say Christ is black. They say, well, color don't matter. Well, if it don't matter, why the hell you change it then?
Exactly.
Why ain't you just leave it alone? Read.
Hebrews chapter 7 and verse 14. For it is evident that our Lord sprang out of Judah.
Our Lord sprang out of Judah. Jesus Christ, our Lord, a black man who sprang out of Judah. Read.
Of which tribe Moses spake nothing concerning priesthood.
Now give me revelation.
Because it said, just told you right there, our Lord sprang out of the black tribe Judah. Judah equals the southern kingdom of the first three names you see on there. Judah, Benjamin, Levi. So-called Haitians and Jamaicans. That's our people. And in the Northern Kingdom is the so-called Hispanics and Native Americans. But we can ready to give you the greatest man that ever walked the planet's color. It said our Lord sprang out of Judah. Judah black, read.
Revelation chapter 1 and verse 14. His head and his hairs were white like wool.
So this is talking about Christ, because John the Revelator was in prison on the Isle of Patmos. He walked with Christ 60 years before he had this revelation, meaning the revealing of. He said his head and his hairs, meaning the hair on his head and the hairs on his face, his beard, were white and woolly. Who got woolly hair in the earth? Think about it. If you take your hair down and compare your hair to wool that comes off a sheep, don't it look the same? That's woolly hair. Read.
As white as snow.
And his hair was white as snow. White in color, woolly in texture. Read.
And his eyes were as a flame of fire.
Because Christ drank wine in moderation. And that's fulfilling the prophecy that Moses told about the Messiah. How we would know who he was, because his eyes would be red because he liked wine in moderation. Read.
And his feet like unto fine brass.
What color is brass, my bro?
Listen in.
Brown, right? Now, not only is it brown, but watch how brown it is. Read.
As if they burned in a furnace.
Burn anything, and what color do it turn? Crispy black. Christ was black.
That's right.
But they told you this was him. And this is the confusion that we talked about earlier. The confusion that's in the land and the seducing doctrines of devils. They lied and told you this was Jesus Christ, when the truth is he looked more like that one over there.
That's right.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold, From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.